In today's video, I am going to explain pathophysiology for knee pain, particularly for people who run a lot. If you are a runner, and if you run like 1 hour, 2 hours almost every day, maybe you have pain on outside of knee. You can apply today's anatomy for outside knee pain. So today's anatomy is for outside. It's not for back part, it's not for inside, it's not for front part. It is for outside knee pain, okay? But before I jump into muscle anatomy, I want you to understand terminology of hip movement. You know, hip joint is here, and her left leg, this hip is on flexion position. So this movement is flexion. This is flexion of hip joint. And back part of leg, this is right leg, this is extension. Okay, leg up, this is flexion. Leg back, this is extension. Today's key movement is flexion. Too much flexion, chronic movement of flexion creates pain on lateral knee. How come? Let me explain important muscles. Okay, I want to explain two deep hip muscles first. This is psoas. Okay, this is psoas. And this is iliacus. Iliacus. These muscles together, it is called iliopsoas. Main function of these two muscles is hip flexion. Hip flexion. You remember what kind of movement that is? This is leg up movement. Thus, iliopsoas is essential for running. They do hip flexion. They bring leg forward. It's important for running, walking, right? However, problem is psoas and iliacus are very, very deep. You don't see that in front of these muscles. What's there? There is large intestine, there is small intestine, there is stomach, there is duodenum, kidneys. Internal organs are in front of these two muscles. Thus, not many people are aware there are such muscles in human body. Actually, there are. If you don't know where these muscles are, how come you can use these two muscles? Exactly. Not many people are able to use iliopsoas for running. Why? Because they are too deep. Plus, in front of these muscles, there are internal organs. That makes even harder to notice there are such muscles. That makes sense. So, usually, these two muscles are ignored. However, size of these two muscles are relatively big. They are thick muscle. Thick muscles don't work. Then what's going to happen? Other hip flexors have to work for these two muscles. Let's focus on other hip flexors. Alright, that was iliopsoas. What kind of hip flexors are there? This is rectus femoris. Rectus femoris. This is sartorius. Sartorius. And this is tensor fasciae latae. Tensor fasciae latae. And other glutes muscles do hip flexion. But I want to focus on tensor fasciae latae. I want to focus on this muscle. Why is this muscle important? Actually, this muscle attaches to here. It's kind of a white, shiny structure. What is this? This is iliotibial band. Iliotibial band, also known as IT band. Sometimes they say ITB or IT band. This is connective tissue. This is from pelvis. Then, it's on lateral part of thigh, It goes to tibia, iliotibial band that connects ilium, pelvis, and tibia. Okay. Again, tensor fascia lata attaches to iliotibial band. Iliotibial band goes to outside knee. Ah, it's gonna be very interesting. Iliopsoas are kind of ignored muscles because they are too deep. Not many people cannot use these two muscles. Then other flexor muscles need to work for iliopsoas. That's compensation. Then, tensor fascia lata is here. That attaches to iliotibial band. Iliotibial band goes to tibia. This is outside knee. So chronic use, repetitive movement of tensor fascia lata creates tension for iliotibial band. This chronic tension can create pain around lateral knee. This is why endurance athletes, endurance runners tend to have lateral knee pain. This is why. So there's one reason people cannot use iliopsoas very well. Then second reason, tensor fascia lata works harder, then that creates tension for iliotibial band. This tension leads to lateral knee pain. Let me explain the same thing for real person model. Where is her tensor fascia lata? It is about here. Now this muscle is working for hip flexion, this way, right? Iliotibial band is about here, okay? Tensor fascia lata attaches to iliotibial band. Chronic movement of tensor fascia lata creates tension on iliotibial band. This connective tissue attaches to tibia. Chronic usage of this muscle creates tension on iliotibial band. This tension creates pain around lateral knee. Huh, that is so important thing. So, solution is one, you train for iliopsoas and you should be aware how to use iliopsoas. Then second solution is you do self-care around tensor fascia lata, maybe iliotibial band, maybe outside knee. Location of tightness depends on people. Maybe some people's tensor fascia lata is the tightest. Maybe iliotibial band is the tightest. Maybe lateral knee is the tightest. The most restriction depends on people. So if you have tightness here, go for it. If you have tightness here, go for it. Now you can apply today's anatomy to solve lateral knee pain. Does it make sense? At last, let me explain muscle that has attachment to iliotibial band. Actually, that is glutes muscle. You see that? This is gluteus maximus. Gluteus maximus actually attaches to iliotibial band. So theoretically, tightness of gluteus maximus can create lateral knee pain. So it's like tensor fascia lata. Glutes attaches to iliotibial band. Tightness of this connective tissue may create pain around lateral knee. Theoretically, that is possible. However, in my personal opinion, tendency is too much use of tensor fascia lata most likely creates pain around lateral knee because gluteus maximus is hard to use. It's hard to contract because that is backside of body. It's backside of body. It's hard to see. It's hard to see. Then it's hard to use. So, anterior part tightness tend to create pain on lateral knee. I don't say this is impossible, but tendency is anterior part is more likely to happen. But this is, you know, for your information. Theoretically, tight gluteus maximus can create lateral knee pain. Let me emphasize, this is not only cause for knee pain. You know, knee joint is freaking complicated structure. But today's reason, today's pathophysiology is freaking common for lateral knee pain. I hope you can apply today's anatomy for your running career. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.